left school a while ago. I mean, I've forgotten half the stuff I was taught, but that's because I haven't needed to use trigonometry once in the real world. Bit of a waste of time if you ask me, but that was then, and this is very much now. I don't know if kids are still being taught algebra and the like, but I do know they are being subjected to some very questionable stuff indeed, as shown by this video from Shaftesbury Kids, with shaft being the operative word.
I'm Nadine, a sex educator.
Hi, Nadine. What little slice of hell are you holding there? It's terrifying. And since when has sex educator been a standalone job? In my day, they got the PE teacher to do the sex education class. That way, everyone was uncomfortable.
And I'm Eva, a sex researcher.
Hello, Eva. Why are you here? I'm assuming this video's for kids, so why do we need a sex researcher? And what even is that job? If it's just watching videos of people going to bone time, then there are a lot of sex researchers in the world.
Today, we're gonna use our sex ed school dolls, Blue and Ginger, to help you guess today's topic.
Oh, geez, they've actually got kids in the room. There's gonna be a lot of questions asked on the ride home, aren't there? You know, questions along the lines of, why did you make me sit through that? And why can't I live with Dad?
Hey, Ginger, I'm Blue. I use the pronouns they and them.
Well, Blue, you're an idiot, because you don't use those pronouns. You expect everyone else to use them, thus putting it on the people around you to validate your gender identity instead of keeping it a you thing, whilst simultaneously coming across as an entitled little prick.
Hi, Blue. Nice to meet you. I'm Ginger, and I use he and him pronouns.
Awesome.
Being gay?
His guess is your guess. Even the subtitles of the original video suggested he said Yankee, but I think he said being gay as the topic of the video, which, I mean, he's not a million miles off, is he?
It's a little bit tough because we're describing something that's inside you and part of how you know yourself.
Any other guesses? Yes.
Being a lesbian?
I thought that too, little man. But alas, this is not going to be as simple as saying some people are homosexuals. No, no. I highly doubt your young mind is prepared for the level of ridiculousness about to be thrown your way.
So it's not quite about, you know, who we have relationships with. It's more about who we understand ourselves to be.
And yet none of these kids have had any problems with that, have they? But they will soon, once you've got your indoctrinating little claws in.
So for example, if I was introducing myself to all of you, I would tell you that I use the pronouns she and her.
What do you mean if? You did introduce yourself to all of them. You said, hi, I'm Nadine, a sex educator. Where were the pronouns, Nadine? Where?
Because I'm a woman, and when I was your age, I used to be a girl.
Is the orange doll touching itself right now? Looks like it's maintaining eye contact with one of the kids too. That's not right, man.
And if I was introducing myself to Nadine and to everyone, I'd also use she, her pronouns.
Well, that was a nice little lesson in redundancy then. I hope you all learned a lot. Time for recess.
So this is the thing that you might think about when you're deciding what clothes you want to wear or how you want to wear your hair.
Nadine, they're like 11. They don't decide what they wear or how they have their hair, hence the lack of gang colors in the classroom right now.
Gender is how you feel on the inside about whether you're a boy or a girl, a man or a woman. If you're non-binary, feel like neither or both.
There's a lot of blank faces right now, Eva. It's almost like you're undoing their basic education in favor of some hip new way of thinking that holds absolutely no water in the world outside your head.
Does anybody know what non-binary means?
It's like when you're neither female or male.
Actually, it means relating to, using, or denoting a system of numerical notation that does not have two as a base. But it's nice to know someone's mother has a septum piercing.
It's an umbrella term, so people can also be fluid, feel more like female, more like male, based on a different day or time. It's really individual.
But how can you feel like the other gender if you've never experienced it? Haven't these same types of people been floating around the idea of male privilege? That is, the thought that a man is incapable of understanding the trials and tribulations of being a woman. How can you have that and also sometimes just feel like a chick? Pick a side!
Absolutely.
Today, we're actually talking about gender.
one's internal sense of maleness, femaleness, neither, both. That's not the definition. Where the hell did you get that? Must be some dictionary when it doesn't use an apostrophe right here. You made that up.
To learn a little bit more about gender, we're gonna play a true or false game.
In other words, show us a rudimentary grasp of biology and we'll tell you you're wrong.
Everyone born with a vulva is a girl, true or false?
Or identifies as a girl.
I'm impressed that the girl who knew what non-binary means is also saying if you have a vagina, then you're a girl. Mummy's gonna be angry at her. And you see this girl here? She was sat at the front a moment ago. Maybe she was moved to the back for stating actual facts.
Not everybody is sure, and that makes sense.
Well, yeah, considering you didn't even explain what a vulva is, Miss Sex Educator.
But our genitals actually don't determine our gender, so some people born with vulvas can be boys.
No, they can say they're a boy, but they aren't actually a boy. I get that you're trying to teach acceptance to children. It's just really weird that you'd rather have them think the entire infrastructure of human knowledge was corrected once Tumblr was launched, instead of just telling them, you know, some people think there are multiple genders, and you have to be careful of what you say around them because they are very angry people who will try to get you fired from your job.
A boy can wear a dress and still be a boy.
Ah, very good. Thus showing your choice of clothing doesn't make you any other gender. Nice. The non-binaries must be raging at that one.
We're all on this, it's true. So you can use how you style your hair or how you get dressed to show your gender to other people.
Wait. You just said a boy can wear a dress and still be a boy. So how does the way you dress show your gender to other people? You're all over the place, Eva. Go do some more sex research.
But there aren't any clothes that are exclusive to one gender.
Except clothing that's tailored for women because their body shape is different to that of a man, and I don't care what current year we're in, I will always take the mickey out of a guy wearing one of these purses.
People of any gender can like or wear any color.
That is true.
Yeah, fine, that is true. But what are the dolls doing now? Someone throw a bucket of cold water on them.
Colors don't have a gender, they're just colors, so you can wear whatever color you like, or whatever color your mom makes you wear.
Aha! See? If you see a little boy rocking around in a floral dress, ask yourself, did he want to wear that? It's like when you see a vegan cat, isn't it? It's very clear who made that decision.
To help us learn a little bit more about gender...
No, hold on. What was that? Flying tits. I just... Well, surely that's some kind of bad omen. I'm pretty sure in the Bible it says, beware the airborne mammaries. And we didn't listen, people. We didn't listen.
We actually have an extra special visitor to sex ed school.
If it's another doll, I'm gonna kick off.
His name is Caleb. He's trans. And he is here to answer all your questions about gender.
Is that the right person for the job? I mean, he's hardly an expert on the matter, is he? You want someone who's been 100% about their gender all their life. Now, that's an expert. I mean, who would you rather have teach you maths? Someone who's never got an answer wrong, or someone who's failed hundreds of tests before finally getting it right?
Oh, hello, everybody.
Ah, man, I'm done. All right, maybe a little longer.
Hi.
I'm Caleb, and I'm here because I do workshops and stuff about gender.
Hey, you in the back, quit screwing around. Sorry, Caleb, please continue.
And so we're gonna talk a little bit about gender. Yes, does everyone have a gender?
Yes.
No, I'm in the toilet.
Did that kid just say toilet? What a gangster! There might just be some hope for this generation yet.
I don't believe that toilet is a gender.
Whoa, Caleb! Why you gotta be such a bigot? If the kid identifies as a toilet, he's a damn toilet and you will address him as such, right? That's what we're supposed to say, isn't it? Yeah? Nailed it. Well, okay then. Now I'm done. There is another 8 minutes to this video, but there's only so much I can take. Not to mention these two demons staring at me all the time. Yeah, I see you, Blue and Ginger. If you want to throw down. Just don't stare at me like a little bitch. Anyway, wasn't that a nice stroll down propaganda lane? And look, if you're worried about the future of those kids, there's no need. Caleb ate them all afterwards. Thanks for watching, guys. Please consider becoming a patron because I clearly need to go back to school. And check me out on BitChute, which is like YouTube, but it doesn't delete your channel for showing a modicum of common sense. The links are in the description, and remember, I identify as someone who doesn't pander to these dicks.